Hi, Larry Wynn with Summit Imaging and Ultrasound and Mammography Equipment Support Organization. And today we have Carolyn again.
Hi, I'm Carolyn Coffin. I'm a consultant for ergonomics with Sound Ergonomics, and I'm also a sonography professor.
So Carolyn is here to, you know, give a different optic and perspective on the errors and failures that we're seeing on transducers. And you know, she's taught a lot of students and used a lot of transducers, a lot of equipment, and has been so valuable to improving our quality program here. And today in particular, we want to actually talk about a 12 to 4 megahertz sector transducer, typically used for cardiac scans, and shoots in between the ribs to get an image of a heart. And today you see a pretty catastrophic failure probe, and we'll talk more about the pulse wave than the no image. So just to be clear here, where our gain is at 86% on this image, and there is nothing. So obviously there's some big problems here, but also because the channels that are carrying the image aren't showing anything, but there is some data being transmitted, unfortunately incorrect data. So this is kind of like a pulsed wave or continuous wave failures, and one of the most common things that we see. So we typically see an image here and then this, but in this particular case, this is a really bad probe, so there's no image here. But let's just kind of focus our conversations here, and Carolyn will kind of tell us what her perspective on these issues, because they're pretty significant.
Well, Larry, if we assume that this is an image of the heart, and the sonographer is trying to demonstrate flow through valves or regurgitant flow back through valves, you want to have a nice, clear Doppler pattern with a good systolic spike and then a nice diastolic component if it's one of the smaller valves. But the problem with these spikes is it's easy to look at it now because this is not a patient, but you're saying, oh yeah, that's definitely broken. But if you're in the heart, it's possible that the Doppler gate, sample gate, is right up against a valve leaflet. So when the valve leaflet hits the sample gate, it can create a very similar spike. And if it's an intermittent problem, it's easy for the sonographers to think, oh, it's just where I've got the sample gate located, and they'll move it, and it'll be fine. And then it occurs again because it's an intermittent problem, and they just think it's themselves. So the lack of understanding of what goes into an image, from the crystals to the connector to the system, can create some artificial confidence in the fact that it's not a transducer issue, but it's just the location of the Doppler sample gate. So basically, you're not getting good, accurate information. And how long could this go on before somebody actually sent the transducer in for repair? Who knows? It depends on how intermittent the signal is. But if this continues to happen and get worse, then the transducer just degrades even further. And then we'll compromise all of the imaging, including the 2D image.
Wonderful. It's those kinds of lessons and instruction that we get from Carolyn that's so valuable, because I can tell you that most technicians that are repairing transducers probably won't have an idea that this can actually be, from a clinician's perspective, actually hitting on top of a leaflet on
in the heart.
And to us, we just see, oh, that's just noise, it's CW noise, it's PW noise. No, it's a lot more than that. What you're trying to resolve is the image quality, so the healthcare providers can give us the best healthcare they can, but they're relying on this really important equipment to do so. And if the equipment's failing like this, it could actually guide them in the wrong spot. It could say that the leaflet might be not working correctly in the heart when it's absolutely fine. And there's a lot of risk that doesn't need to be taken when the probes are properly tested in their entirety and thoroughly at your choice of your ultrasound repair facilities. So
I think Summit Imaging has done a good job of bringing the clinical side in front of the technicians doing the repair. So it's more of a symbiotic relationship between what the clinicians need and what the technicians need, rather than working in silos. It's really important, Larry, that the technicians understand that some of these things can actually occur naturally in the body, or are they really related to the transducer? And I think that the technicians here have been schooled in a little bit more of the patient care side, which is, I think, really valuable for a team like yours.
Yeah, because that's our objective, is that we're here to take care of our customers, which are healthcare facilities, mm-hmm. and taking care of the end customer, which is always the patient, because that could be me, it could be you, it could be yes. one of our family members. And we just want to make sure that we're just pushing the best quality that we can to help our friends and family and the general population that are relying on all of us to push out quality equipment. So, thank you so much for taking the time.
Sure.
Please, if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, follow us on LinkedIn, and we have a lot more videos coming, so talk to you next time. Bye.